In this video, we will explain why the area of a circle is exactly equal to pi multiplied by the radius squared. The length of each side of each square is equal to the radius of the circle. Therefore, the area of each square is the radius squared. The sum of the area of all four squares is therefore 4 multiplied by the radius squared. We can see that the area of the circle needs to be slightly less than the sum of the areas of these four squares. The area of the circle is pi multiplied by the radius squared. The number pi is slightly less than 4. So pi multiplied by the radius squared is slightly less than 4 multiplied by the radius squared. Pi multiplied by the radius squared is the area of the circle. And 4 multiplied by the radius squared is the sum of the areas of the four squares. This is in agreement with our intuitive understanding that the area of the circle needs to be slightly less than the sum of the areas of the four squares. But why is the area of a circle exactly equal to pi multiplied by the radius squared? Why is pi special in a way such that it appears in the equation for the area of a circle? The answer to this has to do with where the number pi comes from. For any circle, if we take the circumference of the circle and divide it by the circle's diameter, we always get the same number, regardless of the size of the circle. We have given a name to this number. The name we selected for this number is pi. The definition of pi is the circumference of a circle divided by its diameter. Therefore, the equation for the area of a circle has something to do with its circumference. We can unroll a circle into n slices, with n approaching infinity, and each slice approaching a perfect triangle. The total length at the bottom is equal to the circle's circumference. The length of the base of each triangle is equal to the circumference divided by the number of triangles. The height of each triangle is equal to the radius of the circle. The area of each triangle is equal to 1/2 of the base multiplied by the height. The area of each triangle is equal to 1/2 of the base multiplied by the height. If we multiply this by the number of triangles, n, we get the total sum of all the areas of all the triangles. The variable n in the numerator cancels out the variable n in the denominator, and the variable n is therefore removed from the equation. The circumference, c, is equal to pi multiplied by the diameter. The diameter is equal to the radius multiplied by 2. Therefore, in the equation for the total area, we can replace the circumference, c, with 2 pi r. The 2 in the numerator cancels out the 2 in the denominator. We replace r multiplied by r with r squared. The sum of the areas of all the triangles is therefore equal to pi multiplied by the radius squared. And the sum of the areas of all the triangles is exactly equal to the area of the circle. Therefore, the area of a circle is exactly equal to pi multiplied by the radius squared. What we just did is essentially an integration in polar coordinates. This is explained in detail in the video, Double Integrals and Polar Integrals. More videos are coming soon. Special thanks to all the people supporting this channel on Patreon. Your support is very much appreciated.